Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. This video is about crankshaft deflection. In my last videos, I have tried to cover mostly everything that is related to bearings, and what all things I have missed out, you can comment down below my videos. All those topics I'll try to cover when I'll make videos on lubrication of bearings. So if you have not watched my videos on bearings, then you can watch them on my page channel, and do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends, as my next set of videos will be on refrigeration, that will cover topics starting from reverse Carnot cycle to the basics of the plants which is there on board ship. So friends, let's begin with the video on crankshaft deflection. Crankshaft deflection is carried out to condition monitor the main bearing. This condition monitoring of main bearing is done by measuring the top clearance, which we have already done, which we have already covered in my last videos. And deflection readings, that is crankshaft deflection, that we will do in this video. Crankshaft deflections are measured to detect the misalignment of the bearing. This misalignment is a type of damage which leads to wear down of the bearing, and this wear down is again leads to more deflection of the crankshaft. So this need to be rectified, found out and then rectified. This misalignment can happen in both horizontal as well as in vertical direction, and it has to be checked in both the directions. So reason of misalignment are plenty. That is, it could be damage or wiping out of the main bearing, loose engine foundation bolt leading to vibration, deformation of ship's hull, cracks in the bearing saddle, loose main bearing bolts leading to damage of main bearing, very high bending moment of the crankshaft due to excessive force on the piston assembly, that is too much peak pressure. Then we have grounding of the ship, then we have crankcase explosion that can affect the misalignment, then defective or worn out stern tube or intermediate shaft wearing. Then we have loosened or broken chokes in the foundation. Then bearing pockets, cracked bed plate deformation, which is there in the transverse girder damage. Then we have tie bolt slacken or broken. Then weakening of the structure due to corrosion. So these are all the reasons for misalignment that can take place. Now let's see how we carry out crankshaft deflection. All the basic paperwork like enclosed space entry and everything, that I won't be covering. I'll just go directly on the onto the point of how the readings are taken, and how we plot the graph by using those readings, and try to find out which all bearings are damaged. So let's start with the crankshaft deflection. Crankshaft deflection readings should be taken while ship is at float. Ship is afloat, that is, it should not be in dry dock. Alignment is influenced by the engine temperature as well as the loading conditions. Deflection measurement should, for comparison purpose, always be made under nearly same temperature and load conditions. As the readings provided by the manufacturer in the manual, they are taken just after ship is put into service. That is, in that at that time ship is it is in light condition. So we should always try to take readings in that condition. That is, temperature condition, loading condition, all those conditions should be much similar to the to those conditions on which the manufacturer have provided the crankshaft deflection readings. For taking out for taking readings, dial gauge is actually placed in the crank throw, opposite to the crank pin, as we can see in the diagram. This is the crank pin and it is placed just opposite on the crank wave. The mounting position is marked on the crank wave. This is a punch mark which is there on the crank wave. Over there we have to place the dial gauge or deflection gauge. Closing of the crank throw is regarded as a negative and opening is regarded as positive. That we take it as assumption during for the readings. Now let's see how we carry out crankshaft deflection. We set this dial gauge or this crankshaft deflection gauge at BP to 0. BP to 0. That is, this BP, P, T, S, B, S and P, these all positions are of crank pin, not of the dial gauge or crankshaft deflection gauge. So it has to be noted, because most of the people, they think that these are the positions of dial gauge, but that is not correct. The readings which the positions which are marked on the diagram, they represents the position of crank pin. So after that, when at BP, when dial gauge is put to 0, then engine is turned clockwise and readings are taken when the crank throw passes through the positions, like at P, at T, at S, at BS. At V we cannot take reading directly, otherwise BP and BS, these two positions are not required, but at V we cannot take the reading directly, so we take reading BP and BS and then we average out the reading for V. So for all the points we take reading P, T, S and BS and we note it down in the table, as you can see. So for VP, all the units it will be 0. All the units it will be 0, and corresponding readings for P, T, S we can note it down in this table. Now after we have noted down the readings in the table, we need to do a little bit calculation. So to take out to find out the bottom position readings, that is B, we have to plus BP and BS and then divide by 2. So that gives the reading of B, point B, position B. So these are the readings of position B. After that, we need to take the vertical deflection and the horizontal deflection. So to calculate the values for vertical deflection, we have to subtract the value of readings in the bottom position from the value in the top position, that is T minus B, which gives 46 for first unit, 6 for second unit, minus 3 for third unit, minus 5.5 for fourth, and so on. Similarly, horizontal deflection, we subtract starboard readings, port readings from starboard readings, so this gives horizontal deflection readings. As I won't be covering plotting of horizontal readings, as it is very much similar to vertical deflection plot. I'll just tell you how to plot vertical deflection readings on the graph. So after vertical position, vertical deflection readings and horizontal deflection readings are calculated, we need to plot the graph. But before that, I would like to tell you one more point which I have learned on the internet, but I'm not sure whether that is correct or not, is that what I read was B plus P plus B and P plus S, that is top position reading and bottom position reading summation, will be equal to starboard side plus port side readings. The summation will be almost equal, like suppose T plus B will be approximately equal to P plus S. But I don't know whether this is correct, but it is given in one of the websites on the net. So now let's carry out how to plot the readings. So for plotting the readings, we need to draw the crank pin. This is the crank pin. The top part is the crank pin, and the bottom part, this one, is the main bearing. So for all the units, we just need to draw, and we need to draw the center line of all the crank pin bearings. Then after that, we need to draw a reference line. This is the reference line. Now from reference line, we need to draw minus 46 on the center line of number 2 unit of crank pin. So this is drawn. Let me change the color. So this minus 46 is drawn like this. After that, the point on the reference line, which is this one, the point A, is joined with point B. So we get this triangle. So to draw the next reading, let me just zoom this area. As we can see, we have drawn 46, and then after that we have joined, this is the reference line, after that we have joined this to B. So what we have to do is, after joining B, we have to extrapolate the same line to B dash, which intersects on the center line of number 3 unit crank pin bearing. Okay, and then from B dash we have to draw a vertical line with a magnitude of minus 6. So this vertical line is drawn like this, as you can see. And then finally we join B to C. B to C is joined. So what we get? We get a triangle B, B dash, and C. So after this triangle is drawn, the other reading is plotted in the same manner, and all the readings are plotted, as you can see in the graph. This graph, as we can see, we have plotted all the readings for all 6 units. After plotting all the units, what we have to do is, we have to just join these points, like suppose A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, and get a smooth curve like this one. This is a smooth curve which we get. After getting a smooth curve, we have to draw tangent to the curve. Suppose this is the tangent, and the bearings which have fault, they will be away from the tangent. So that detects how that tells which all bearings are having faults or are wore down or having misalignment. The bearings which are away from this tangent which is drawn on the curve. So one precaution we have to take while taking reading of last 3 unit is that when this turning gear is stopped, on each stoppage a little bit backward movement is given to ease of the tangential pressure on the turning wheel teeth. Otherwise this pressure may falsify the reading. Now suppose we have done everything, and we found that there is a fault in one of the bearing. Like suppose in my slides, I have taken these readings from the manual, which is provided by the manufacturer after the ship is put into service for the first time, which is in light condition. So there won't be any fault in the bearings, as we can see from the graph itself. So to just tell you if fault is there, what kind of graph it will be. So if fault is there, the graph will be like this, like as we can see here. It is moving in this direction, then suddenly it goes like this. So this bearing, it's faulty. So after knowing which bearing is faulty, we need to just open that bearing and see if it is really worn down or there is misalignment in the bed plate. So if after opening, if bearing is found is in good condition, then we should contact the manufacturer and ask for bed plate alignment. So friends, this is all about crankshaft deflection. Same way, we have to carry out plotting for the horizontal readings that I have not shown in this video. Hope you have enjoyed this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. Till then, thank you, take care, and have fun.